humbly pray you, deliver this to my lord the king.
Most willing, madam.
In which I have commended to his goodness the model of our chaste loves, his young daughter. The dews of heaven forsaken blessings on her, beseeching him to give her virtuous breeding. She is young, and of a noble, modest nature. I hope she will deserve well, and a little to love her for her mother's sake that loved him heaven knows how dearly. My next poor petition is that his noble grace would have some pity upon my wretched women that so long have followed both my fortunes faithfully, of which there is not one. I dare avow, and now I should not lie, but will deserve for virtue and true beauty of the soul, for honesty and decent carriage, a right good husband. Let him be a noble, and sure those men are happy that shall have him. The last is for my men. They are the poorest, but poverty can never draw them from me. That they may have their wages duly paid them, and something over to remind me by. If heaven had pleased to have given me longer life or able means, we had not parted thus. These are the whole contents, and good, my lord, by that which you love dearest in this world, as you wish Christian peace to souls departed, stand these poor people's friend, and urge the king to do me this last rite.
By heavens, I will. Or let me lose the fashion of a man.
Thank you, honest lord. Remember me, in all humility unto his highness. Say that his long trouble now is passing out of this world. Tell him that in death I blessed him, for so I will. Mine eyes grow dim. Farewell, my lord. Nay, patience. You must not leave me yet. I must to bed. Call in more women. When I am dead, good wench, let me be used with honour. Strew me over with maiden flowers, that all the world will know I was a chaste wife to my grave. Embalm me, and lay me forth. Although unqueened, yet like a queen, and daughter to a king. Inter me, I can no more.